Philip and Nancy Garrido back in court in El Dorado County this afternoon. They're charged with kidnapping and raping Jaycee Dugard. KCRA3's Lindsay Paulo is live in Placerville with a preview and new photos that may be soon for surfacing about Jaycee and her daughters.
Yeah, well, this is a scheduled hearing this afternoon for Philip and Nancy Garrido as they inch a little bit closer toward a trial date. Not much is expected to happen in the court behind me later this afternoon. However, meanwhile, the spokesperson for Jaycee Dugard is speaking out today about some new photos, unauthorized photos that have surfaced, and she is very outraged about media outlets that may be trying to profit off of Dugard's image. Jaycee Dugard released these photos of her family to People magazine last October. She controlled when and where they were taken and published. But now, Dugard spokesperson Nancy Seltzer says someone has taken new unauthorized photos of Dugard and her daughters and is selling them. Seltzer sent us this statement today. Jaycee Dugard is a person who has been through the unimaginable. Her daughters are attempting to enter the world without people pointing fingers. Philip and Nancy Garrido were charged with kidnapping Dugard when she was 11 years old and holding her captive, repeatedly raping her until she was discovered last August. She bore two daughters to Garrido in captivity. Her spokesperson says the new photos were taken last weekend. She does not know who photographed them, but says a photo agency in the U.S. is offering them for sale. She says the National Enquirer and Globe news magazines bought them, but agreed to blur the daughters' faces. Seltzer says, while I thank those publications for choosing to blur the images of Jaycee's daughters' faces, I can only feel shame for those who took the photos and think this is right. Now, Seltzer told me that Dugard is not a public person by choice, and she hopes that the media and others will respect her privacy. Live in Placerville, Lindsay Paulo, KCRA 3 reports.
Any word, Lindsay, on how they're doing?
Yeah, Seltzer says that they really are trying to assimilate and live their life as a family. She says they do go out. In fact, she said she went with Jaycee and the girls to a shopping mall and no one really noticed or knew who they were or cared. She says that Dugard is a fabulous writer, that she's writing every week, and that there may be a time in the future when those writings become public. She also says that Dugard hopes to form a nonprofit in the future to help survivors of violent crime.
Lindsay Paulo live in Placerville with the preliminary hearing coming up in just a little bit. Lindsay, thank you.